services on Tuesday and Thursday. And Friday we'll have an overnight service. So we invite you, if you can, please come and join us. Praise God. We are continuing with our teaching series on the study of the first and second book of Corinthians. Our series today is the study of the book of first and second Corinthians. Once we finish the study of the book of Corinthians, we will start the study of the book of Ephesians. Of all the books in the Bible, my favorite is the book of Ephesians. I love all the books in the Bible, but my favorite is the book of Ephesians and the book of Acts. So I believe once we finish the study of 1st and 2nd Corinthians, we will study the book of Ephesians. Then after Ephesians, we will study the book of Romans. The book of Romans is also a wonderful book. The book of Romans was written from Ephesus, and the book of Romans was written at Corinth. Paul spent 3 months at Corinth, and then he wrote the book of Romans, and then when he was at Ephesus, he wrote the book of Corinthians. Paul's oldest book, the first book he wrote, is the book of Galatians. We'll study Galatians after we have studied Romans. That's when we'll be able to understand it. I have realized that the Church of Christ needs to be taught so that we can receive the wisdom of God. The reason why many Christians do not grow spiritually is because they read only one verse and they walk by it. Then when they meet people who have been misled in many verses, they mislead them as well. I met 2 Jehovah's Witnesses in Kenya. They came to teach me. I was close to Nairobi Hospital. They were 2 ladies and they stopped me and they said, "We would like to talk to you about the kingdom of God."
No.
So I allowed them. They must have regretted for doing that. Usually they walk in pairs, and one of the two is a learner. They are learning from the experienced one. So because I knew their system, I confronted the one who was not speaking, who was not knowing anything.
We
try to debate and argue. And so I'll tell her, I'll let you talk, but I would also like to ask, and I want to ask whoever I want.
Noneho nangiye kubaza wa wundi bibazo aravangirwa mbona kujya mureba hafi kumukubita urushyi aramubwiye ngo va havuba amufata ukuboko baragenda bimyoza barakaye namubwiye abantu bari mu mwuka w'Imana ko mwimyoza muze tuganire ijambo ry'Imana yagiye arakaye cyane.
When she realized it was becoming too much for her companion, she decided to rebuke her and tell her to run away. And I told her, how can you get angry when you are talking about the word of God? Let's talk. Let's remain here and talk.
Ariko baza kumenya, baza kunyohereza umusore wabyize cyane.
Then they realized they could not compete with me, so they sent a highly trained one.
Uwo musore kuko angendaho.
And that young man followed me.
Chuge yaje wenyine.
He came alone.
Wa musore.
The young man.
Ndamubwira ati ngendaganira nawe muri Bibiliya yanyu.
And I told him, I want to argue with you using your own Bible, the Jehovah Witnesses Bible.
Musaba amavensa arindwi wayansomere atanditswe muri Bibiliya yaba arayabura. Arangije arambwira ngo sasa weye ati njyewe ndabona wiyemeje kudetruiza kwizera kwanjye ndambwira ariko niwe wansanze waje kugira ngo unyigishe umpindure sinzi udetruiza uwundi usenya uwundi. Umusore arakara cyane nawe arakaye ndamwinga nawe ati wirakara ko turaganira nari muhaye gusa ibyanditswe bikeya ndamubwira ati reba uyu murongo muri Bibiliya asanga utarimo undi muri bibiri asanga utarimo undi muri bibiri asanga yaye mirongo irindwi arangije ararakara avuga ati wewe ndabona urashaka gusenya kwizera kwanjye ndavuga ni wewe washatse gusenya kwanjye nihagazeho iyo ndihagaraho nanjye uba wansenya niko bimera iyo umuntu atagusenye nawe uramusenya iyo agusenye nawe donc iyo agutanze niko bigenda ndavuga ati wowe wajuje kunsenya none urasenyutse utangiye kurakara. Gusoma ibyanditswe gusoma Bibiliya bituma iyi si tubasha kuyicamo tukayimenya nawe ubundi bazababaza ibintu ntimubimenye kuko abakristo rero badafite ubumenyi buhagije bw'ijambo ry'Imana numvishe mu bihe turi kumwe namwe twakwiga Bibiliya tuzaba dufata igitabo tukaciga namwe mukamenya ijambo ry'Imana mugasobanuka ijambo ry'Imana siko twese tuzagirirwa ubuntu bwo kujya muri teoloji ngo tujye kuyiga ariko hari niburi cyufite cyutunze tukikwigisha uko gikora murumva ari gahunda nziza Imana ibaho umugisha. Ntabwo nzabigisha teoloji classique ngo mbigishe donc ningire muri za exegese ningire muki ariko nibura nzagerageza kubaha Bibiliya mu buryo ntawapfa kugushuka hariya hanze donc umenye impamvu igitabo cyanditswe umenye impamvu ibi bivugwa umenye donc usobanukirwe ufite iyo contexte mu mutwe wawe historique culturelle ibyo byose bizatuma ubasha kumenya ijambo ry'Imana. Imana ishimwe cyane. Turimo turaganira rero igitabo cy'Abakorinto.
We are studying the book of Corinthians.
Igitabo cy'Abakorinto cyandikiwe abakijijwe.
This book was written for the believers.
Ntabwo cyandikiwe abapagani.
Not for the pagans.
Cyandikiwe mbere na mbere abakristo b'i Korinto.
Number one, it was addressed to the believers at Corinth.
Icya kabiri cyandikirwa abantu biyemeje guhamagarwa kwera.
It was also written for the people who were determined to obey their calling of holiness.
Actually, who are called to become a saint.
Who are called to become saints.
Babari abahamagariwe kwera.
Those who are called to become saints.
Icya gatatu cyandikiwe abantu bambaza izina ry'umwami wacu Yesu Kristo aho bari hose bidatewe n'igihugu aho umuntu wese ari yambaza Yesu Kristo.
Third, it was written for those who worship, who call on the name of the Lord wherever they are in any nation in the world.
Ni ukuvuga ngo rero si cy'abapagani.
And so it is not a book for the pagans.
Mu rurimi tuzi rwo gipagani.
In our understanding of that term.
Si igitabo cy'abantu batizera Imana.
It is not a book for the non-believers.
Ni igitabo cy'abizera Imana.
But for the believers.
Ibyo tubimenya gute?
How do we know that?
Tubimenya duhaereye muri mu gice cya mbere.
We see that in chapter 1 of 1 Corinthians.
Ku murongo wa kabiri.
Verse 2.
Aravuga ngo turabandikiye mwebwe abo mu itorero ry'Imana ry'i Korinto. Berejwe muri Kristo Yesu kandi abahamagariwe kuba bera. Icya gatatu. N'abantu bose bambariza hose izina ry'umwami wacu Yesu Kristo ariwe mwami wabo n'uwacu. Aba nibo bahamagariwe babandikiwe iki gitabo.
To the church of God which is at Corinth, to those who are sanctified in Christ Jesus, called to be saints, with all who in every place call on the name of Jesus Christ our Lord, both theirs and ours. There you have it. That is the audience for this book. Why did Paul write to the Corinthians? He preached the gospel there and they got converted. Then later, he received the report that the Christians whom he converted, when they go out in the world, they commit sins like the people of the world. They commit the things the world commits. When they come back to the house of God, they do the requirements God has for them. They go outside the church, they become like the people outside. When they come to the church, they behave like the saints. And that hurt Paul. How can you have double standards at the same time? That amazed him. If you are saved, you should not behave like the people of the world. Rather, you should do good things so that the people of the world will have positive jealousy and then come over to you. Yet for you, it seems the world still attracts you. And it looks you don't have the power to attract the world, rather the world is attracting you. And that amazed Paul, to see the things people had abandoned and now they are going back to the same things. When you are before the church, you behave as if you abandon the old practices of the world, but when you go back to the people outside, you behave like them.
Ibyo rero bituma intumwa ibandikira uko umuntu atagomba kwifatanya n'abo mwijima niba ari umucyo, atagomba kwifatanya na Beliyari niba ari uwa Kristo, atagomba kwifatanya na bamaraya niba aramenye Yesu. Ibyo bituma Paul abitindaho. Rero umwijima ubu mwijima, umucyo ubu mucyo, abandikira urwandiko.
And that's why Paul wrote this letter to the Corinthians, to tell them that if you are in darkness, do not mix. If you are in light, do not go back to darkness. If you worship demons, not come and worship God again. You have to be holy if you are holy.
Aha Paul rero yababwiye ibintu bibiri bihabanye.
Paul told them two things that are contrary to each other. He talked of the power of heaven and the power of the world. He told them about the wisdom of heaven and the wisdom of the world. He told them of the spirit of heaven and the spirit of the world. Usually the power of heaven should overcome the power of the world. Normally the spirit of heaven should overcome the spirit of the world. Normally the wisdom of heaven should overcome the wisdom of the world. But how could it be that you, with the wisdom of God, with the power of God, with the spirit of God, the world overpowers you? And then he wrote to them. He wrote to them about the plan of God. He wrote to them about what God had predestined before, how they must walk in such power, how he purposed and how he determined to preach the message of the gospel in their city. Chapter 1, verse 18. Our message today is how the things of God are contrary to the things of God, of the world. When you are in the things of God, you must be different from the things of the world. That's what Paul was telling them, that I want to talk about to you also today, this afternoon. Chapter 1, verse
18. kuko byanditswe ngo nzarimbura ubwenge bw'abanyabwenge n'ubuhanga bw'abahanga nzabuhindura ubusa.
The Bible says, for the message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise and bring to nothing the understanding of the prudent.
Mbese none umunyabwenge arihe, umwanditsi arihe, umunyampaka wo muri iki gihe arihe, ubwenge bw'iyisi Imana ntiyabuhinduye ubupfu.
Verse 20, where is the wise? Where is the scribe? Where is the disputer of this age? Has not God made foolish the wisdom of this world?
Kuko ubwenge bw'Imana bwategetse ko abisi badaheshwa kumenya Imana n'ubwenge bw'isi. Imana yishimiye gukirisha abayizera ubupfu bw'ibibwirizwa.
For since in the wisdom of God, the world through wisdom did not know God, it pleased God through the foolishness of the message preached to save those who believe the power of God and the wisdom of God.
Kuko ubupfu bw'Imana burusha abantu ubwenge kandi intege nke z'Imana zirusha abantu imbaraga.
Because the foolishness of God is wiser than men, and the weakness of God is stronger than men.
Muzirikane guhamagara ibyo mwisi bikoze isoni ibikomeye.
For you see your calling, brethren, that not many wise according to the flesh, not many mighty, not many noble, not are called, but God has chosen the foolish things of the world to put to shame the wise, and God has chosen the weak things of the world to put to shame the things which are mighty.
Kandi nibyorohejwe mu isi nibihinyurwa nibitariho Imana yabitoranije ngo ihindure ubusa ibiriho kugira ngo atagire umuntu wirata imbere y'Imana. Niyo ibaha kuba muri Kristo Yesu waduhindukiye ubwenge buva ku Mana no gukiranuka no kwezwa no gucungurwa kugira ngo bibe nk'uko byanditswe ngo uwirata yiratu witeka. Amen.
And the best things of the world and the things which are despised God has chosen, and the things which are not to bring to nothing the things that are, that no flesh should glory in his presence. But of him you are in Christ Jesus, who became for us wisdom from God and righteousness and sanctification and redemption, that as it is written, he who glories, let him glory in the Lord. I want us to repeat again verse 25.
Ubupfu bw'Imana burusha abantu ubwenge, intege nke z'Imana zirusha abantu imbaraga.
Because the foolishness of God is wiser than men, and the weakness of God is stronger than men.
Ubupfu bw'Imana burusha abantu ubwenge, intege nke z'Imana zirusha abantu imbaraga.
The foolishness of God is wiser than men, and the weakness of God is stronger than men.
Kugira ngo ibitubyumve neza bene data,
for us to understand this, brethren,
hari uburyo butatu Imana yakoze.
There are three ways in which God did things.
Kugira ngo ibashe gucungura isi cyangwa se ibashe guhindura abantu,
for him to be able to redeem the world and change people.
Ikintu cya mbere Imana yakoresheje ubwenge bwayo.
Number one, God used his wisdom.
Icya kabiri Imana yakoresheje imbaraga zayo.
Number three, he used his power.
Icya gatatu Imana yakoresheje umwuka wayo.
Number two, he used his power. Number three, he used his spirit.
Untegere neza.
Listen to me.
Imbaraga z'Imana zigeze mu isi,
when the power of God came to the world,
zaje ari intege nke.
It came as weakness.
Yesu yaje aciye bugufi cyane.
Jesus came humbled.
Ubwenge bw'Imana bugeze ku isi,
when the wisdom of God came to this world,
bwaje bugaragara ari nk'ubuswa.
It came appearing as foolishness.
Umwuka w'Imana ugeze kuri iyi si,
when the spirit of God came to this world,
bwaje ugaragaje nk'udafite imbaraga.
It came as if it was powerless.
Ariko ibyo nibyo byahinduye abantu.
But yet these are the things that changed men.
Niba mwasomye mwumvishe rero,
if you have read and heard what the Bible says,
Paul aravuga ngo,
Paul is saying,
tugomba kubwiriza umusaraba.
We must preach the cross.
Tugomba kuvuga ubutumwa bw'umusaraba.
We must preach the message of the cross.
N'ubutumwa bwa Kristo w'abami.
And the message of Jesus crucified.
Kugira ngo imbaraga z'abantu zibashe gushingiraho.
So that the power of men will be based on that.
Igihe cya Paulo isi yari igabanyijemo ibice bibiri.
In the days of Paul, the world was in two sections.
Mu buryo bw'idini.
Religiously speaking.
Hari isi y'Abayuda.
There was the world of the Jews.
N'isi y'Abanyamahanga.
And the world of the Gentiles.
Abanyamahanga bose bitwa Abagiriki.
All Gentiles were represented by the Greeks. Because the world had been colonized by the Greeks. Everyone who was not Jewish was regarded as a Gentile.
Donc umunyamahanga yarinde.
Who was a Gentile?
N'umuntu utarizeraga Imana y'Abayuda.
Anybody who didn't worship the God of the Jews.
Iyo wabaga umunyamahanga.
When you are a Gentile.
Ukemera Imana y'Abayuda.
And you converted to Judaism and accepted their God when you were Greek.
Babitaga abaproselite cyangwa se abantu bahindukiye bakafata Imana itari yabo.
They would call them proselytes, those who converted to accept their God, the God who was not their own God.
Abagiriki nyabagiriki babitaga abahelenic.
But true original Greeks were called Hellenists. But all other Gentiles were symbolically represented in the Greeks because their language was popular at the time. In the days of Paul and in the days of Jesus. The culture of the Greeks was all over in the world, but also the language that was spreadly used was Latin. So those two groups of people, the people of the Jews, the Jews had the true God, and there were the Gentiles. Each nation among the Gentiles had their own God. Every nation had many gods depending on the tribes and families in that nation. Now the ministry of Paul was number one to first know the true God of the Jews.
Hanyuma yamana akayigemurira abanyamahanga bakareka ibigo mana zabo bakakira yamana nyakuri.
And then take that God, the true God of the Jews, to the Gentiles so that they would stop worshiping idols.
Abayuda bemeraga imana yo mwijuru ariko ntibemeraga imana ko yaje kwisi ari we Yesu. Rero kugira ngo umuyuda azabyemere byatwaraga igihe kirekire.
The Jews believed in the God of heaven, but they never believed that Jesus came as God in this world. It was so hard for them to accept that. What did that require? Another power. For you to convince a Jewish person that Jesus is God. Because they believe God cannot be born, God cannot get old, God cannot die.
Ariko bari bazi mu byanditswe byabo ko Imana izaza mu shusho ya Masiya.
Yet they knew that in their holy scriptures God would come in the form of the Messiah.
Rerige Masiya yaziye ntibabimenye.
But when the Messiah came they didn't understand.
Babona ari umwana gusa uvutse ubyirutse uvuye mu giturage cy'i Nazareti wiyita Masiya. Birabababaza cyane kumva uyu mwana yigereranya, biyemeza no kumwica kugira ngo ibyo uyu mwana avuga biveho byibagirane. Naho kumwica nibyo byatumye bigera kure bituma Paul akizwa.
They saw him when he was born as a young boy born in Israel and grew up in Nazareth, who was claiming to be the Messiah. They did not accept him and they actually went all the way to killing him. Yet in the process of killing him, that's how the power of Christ was manifest. And that's what Paul was preaching. So when Paul got saved, he was in Judaism and he was amazed. If this is true, my people are in darkness. For Jesus came to redeem them, but they happened to have that. Now I, Paul, I want to preach to my people. Paul had dual citizenship. He had the Israeli citizenship and Roman citizenship. God had predestined him to preach the gospel to the Jews and the Gentiles without any barrier. And that helped Paul to learn the Jewish culture as well as the Gentile culture.
Imbaraga za Paul, kumenyekana kwa Paul, nuko yasimze imbibizi wabo akajya mu mahanga.
The strength of Paul and the fame of Paul came because he had the culture of his own people that he and he also lived among the Gentiles.
Sewa Paul na nyina wa Paul.
Paul's father and mother,
baraba Yuda.
They were Jews.
Ariko ntibabaga muri Israel.
But they did not live in Israel.
Babaga muri Asia.
They lived in Minor Asia.
Mu bice za Itarusi.
In Tarsus.
Itarusi bari batuye.
Tarsus, their hometown.
Chakara gace kayobowe n'Abaroma.
Was the Roman colony,
icyo twita Turikiya ya none,
which is in modern day Turkey.
Naho Paul yavukiye,
that's where Paul was born.
Kuvukira rero I Taruso,
him to be born in Tarsus,
byatumaga avuka ari umuroma,
made him born as a Roman citizen naturally.
Avuka n'ubwenegihugu bw'abaroma.
He was born with the Roman citizenship.
Ariko mu maraso na none ni umuyuda.
But in the blood he was also a Jew.
Yize imico y'ikiyuda.
He learned Jewish culture.
Yiga imana y'ikiyuda.
He learned the God of the Jews.
Aba umufarisayo w'abayuda.
He became a Pharisee among the Jews.
Amaze kumenya Yesu,
when he knew Jesus,
noneho aratangara cyane.
He got amazed.
Asanga isi divijemo kabiri.
He saw the world was divided into two.
Hari igice cy'abayuda n'igice cy'abagiriki.
There was the section of Jews and that of the Greeks.
Nivuga abagiriki,
when I speak of the Greeks,
wumve uburyo bwagutse.
Think of the Greeks in a broader term.
N'abantu bose batari abayuda.
That included all people that were not Jews.
Abanyarwanda.
That includes Rwanda.
Abarundi.
Burundians.
Abanyekongo.
Congolese.
Bagande.
Ugandans.
Abakenya.
Kenyans.
Abo n'abagiriki.
All those who were in the Greek section.
Bitwaga
they were called Gentiles.
Mu rurimi rundi bitwaga abapagani.
In other terms, they were known as pagans.
Abapagani n'abantu batemeraga Imana ya Isiraeli bari bafite izindi mana. Nicyo bisobanura abantu bapratikaga imigenzo y'imico y'iwabo itari mu muco w'Imana ya Isiraeli.
Pagans were people who were religiously not following the God of Israel, who were having other gods that they worshipped in their own tribes and nations.
Rero abayuda,
now Jews,
kugira ngo uzamwemeze Yesu Kristo,
for you to convince them about Jesus,
uzamwemeze ko ari umucunguzi,
to convince Jesus is the Redeemer,
wagombaga kwerekana ibimenyetso.
You had to prove with signs.
Hari ibitangaza bigomba kugaragara.
There had to be signs and miracles.
Kubagiriki,
to the Greeks,
wagomba kwerekana ubwenge.
You had to prove by intellect.
Mukajimbaka,
you had to debate,
kugeza igihe umutsindi,
until you convinced them completely.
Abagiriki,
the Greeks,
baratonganaga.
They used to argue and have quarrels and debate,
kugira ngo umwe yemeze undi,
so that one would convince the other.
Bananiranwa mu bitekerezo.
When they failed the intellectual debate, they would say, let us wrestle physically and see who is going to overcome the other. We have failed to win the debate. Now let us use your physique, your strength.
Aho niho imico yo gukirana yavaga.
That's how wrestling sports started.
Barabanye mpaka cyane.
They were people of debates and arguments.
Kandi bari abantu bagira barimo bakurikira.
And they had philosophers that they followed.
Nk'umwe mu babo bakomeye,
one of the prominent philosophers,
witwaga Socrates,
was called Socrates.
Yari afite abantu.
He had his students.
Mu bigishwa be.
And some of his students.
Harimo abigishwa babiri bakomeye.
There were two who were powerful.
Babashe kujana ubutumwa bwe.
They were able to take his message.
Hari uwitwaga Xenophon.
One was called Xenophon.
Hari undi witwaga Plato.
Another was called Plato.
Aba bari abigishwa ba Socrates.
These were students of Socrates.
Mu mico yabo rero.
So in their culture.
Umugiriki.
A Greek.
Bamwemeraga.
Would only be accepted.
Kubera ibintu bitatu.
Because of three things.
Icyambere.
Number one.
N'ubwenge.
It is wisdom.
Iyo ufite ubwenge.
When you had wisdom,
babumenyeraga he?
How they know you?
Kugira abantu benshi bagukurikiye.
By having many followers.
Abo bagukurikiye,
those who your followers,
nabo bakagenda bavuga bwa bwenge bwabo.
They would go around spreading your wisdom.
Niyo havu ijambo
spreading your philosophy. That's where the word philosophy came from.
Philo. Sophia.
Sophia.
Philosophy. Philosophia.
Philosophia.
Sophia n'ubwenge.
Sophia is wisdom.
Philo n'ukwiga.
Philo is studying.
Donc umuntu wigisha ubwenge bamwitaga umufilosofe.
So somebody who taught wisdom was called a philosopher.
Philos Sophia.
Philosophia.
Rero Paul aje kuvuga ubutumwa mu bagiriki.
So when Paul went to preach the gospel among the Gentiles, yirinze
kujyayo ngufite Philos na Sophia.
He did not want to go as someone with Philos and Sophia.
Kuko bari bafite abantu bemera.
Because they had many philosophers.
Socrates. Baremera Plato.
Xenophon.
Ndetse na Aristotle. Abo ni abanyatenayi bose.
All these were Athens Greeks.
Abo bari abantu bakomeye.
They are prominent.
Ikindi cyabarangaga.
Another characteristic of a Greek.
Cyari kinyabufura.
Was no, being
kuba
noble.
Noble.
To be noble.
Iyo abantu bagukurikiraga bemeraga ngo ufite imico myiza ituma abantu bagukurikira ubabera icyitegererezo.
When you had multitudes following you, they believed you must be having you must be a person of nobility, you must be noble and having integrity. That's why people are following you.
Noble, noble.
Noble. Somebody who has integrity. The third characteristic of the Greek was not changing what you believe. A philosopher had their school of thought that they believed in, and they would not be converted by another person. That's how they believed. They would believe that nobody should change their stand in their belief. There were radicals in their beliefs. What the Greeks not believing is somebody who has been followed by multitudes. Then later they would discover that they were mistaken about this person. What they would do, they would crucify such a person. They would put that person on a tree and hang them to be a lesson to others. So to hang that person on a tree would mean this person is an accursed. When somebody is cursed, nobody would follow them. They would follow someone who is noble, someone who has a good idea. Now for Paul to preach the gospel to the Greeks and tell them Jesus was crucified, it was very difficult.
Bakamubaza se ubuzima bwe bwabayeho gute akababwira number 1 ko atagize se ku munyabwenge w'umugiriki arabwo ngo kwa tujye muri mathematics muri logic ikintu cyose kigira origine Yesu origine ni iyi icyakabira akababwira ngo uko yakuza uwo mwana yakuza ari controverse mu abantu batamwemera bukeye baramubamba uwo niwe nemeye byari birangiye kutongera kuvuga ubutumwa mu bakori.
For Paul to start preaching to a Greek person and start by saying, the man I believe, the man whom I follow as my philosopher in that regard, is his name is Jesus. Number one, he was born without a father. That is the problem, number one. Number two, he was a controversial man, that he was crucified. To a Greek audience, that was enough. They would not have any other word with you.
Socrate afite se na nyina, Plato afite se na nyina, Xenophon afite se na nyina. Dufite aho bakomoka. Wewe philosophe wa wavahe?
Socrates, Xenophon and Plato, all these philosophers had their fathers. Where is your leader coming from? Who is their father?
Paul amaze kuvuga ubutumwa wa Korinto.
When Paul had finished preaching to
the gato,
he left briefly.
Yasanze abakorinto kubera kiritire yo kwemera umuntu bariremye mu ibice.
Because of the Greek culture at Corinth of following a leader or a philosopher, they ended up having divisions in the church. In the Corinthian church, there were followers of Apollos. For us, we believe in Apollos. He is an eloquent man. He has rhetoric. He can talk. Others said, no, for us, we are for Paul. Others, we are for
Kephas.
Others, we are for Christ. After in the church, they would have debates in the church. Tell us why you followed Apollos.
Now, Paul.
And tell us why you
now
followed Paul or Kephas.
Now,
or Christ. They would come to a church service and the church would be full of debates. And so because they had the influence of the Greek culture where they had philosophers they were following, that spirit is the same they brought to the church and began to apply it in the church. They wanted to have the same spirit of debates in the world and bring it in the church. And Paul was confused with that. He said some are for Apollos, others for Kephas, others for Paul, others for Christ. What is that? What are you telling me?
Philosophe Aristanei Socrate.
Socrates' philosophy.
Igiye charageze.
Time, the philosopher Socrates, time came for him.
Baramugambanire.
And he was betrayed.
Bamugambaniye.
When he was betrayed,
bamushira mu nzu y'imbohe.
They imprisoned him,
baziko bazamwica mu minsi irimbere.
Planning to kill him in the future.
Urupfu bagombaga kumwica.
His death, his manner of death,
rwarugo kumubamba.
Was crucifixion.
Abigishwa be.
Now his students,
abamukurikiraga,
his followers,
bari bafite ubushobozi,
they had the ability,
bwo gutanga ruswa mu bari bamuzengurutse bamurinze kugira ngo asohoke ahunge,
to bribe the guards who were guarding Socrates so that they could release him to run away.
Ariko babihuzwa n'impamvu eshatu.
But they did not do that because of three reasons.
Impamvu ya mbere,
first reason,
imfura nditanga ruswa.
A noble person will not give bribes.
Socrates yabigisha kuba imfura, iyo proposition bayikubita hasi gatoya, imfura nditanga ruswa.
Socrates had trained them to be men of integrity, and so they said the question of bribe is out.
Icyagatatu.
Number two,
imfura ntiyivuguruza ibyo yemera ibipfiramo.
A noble person, a noble man will not change their mind.
He never compromised.
They will never compromise. They will accept to die for what they believe for.
Icyo yemeye aragipfira.
Whatever they believe, they are ready to die for it.
Icyagatatu.
Number three.
Naramuka hunze.
If he flees,
icyo azaba agiye kuvuga handi,
what he is going to tell others,
kibazacyemera handi kuko yagihunze iwabo,
will not be accepted because he has fled for it where he was.
None bemezanya n'intumwa ze.
Now they agreed with his messengers
ko yemera
that he should accept
gupfa
to die.
Ero ikibazo nacyo ni iki?
Now the problem was this.
Socrates sintinya gupfa.
Socrates, I'm not afraid of death.
Ariko mfite ikibazo.
But my problem
nuruhe rupfu banyica.
What kind of death are they going to kill me?
Nugu musaraba.
It is the death of crucifixion.
Naramuka apfuye urupfu rw'umusaraba.
If he accept to die on the cross.
Ibintu byose yigishije abantu nibyo yemeye mubagira ikibazo avuga ko ari umuvumo.
Everything he stood for, everything he taught to the Greeks, it would be regarded as a curse. Because a crucified person is not a person of nobility. They are not noble. And he was having a trouble. So he agreed with his students. He said, give me poison, let me commit suicide, rather than dying tomorrow on the cross. Let them find me dead already. They brought the poison.
Atangiye kunywa.
He began to drink.
Ubwo burozi,
that poison,
bwateraga ikinya uhereye ku birenge ukageza mu mutima,
would paralyze the person from the sole of the foot to the heart.
Amaze kugotomira icupa ry'uburozi.
After drinking this bottle full of poison,
akomeza agenda aho mu nzu y'imbohe.
He kept walking in prison.
Agenda.
Walking in prison.
Kugeza igihe,
until a point,
yasabye uwamuhaye uburozi.
He asked the one who gave him the poison,
kubita ibirenge byanjye numve ko biki.
He told him, strike my feet, I want to see if I can still feel. When they began to beat his feet, he said, I can't feel anything. And the poison was coming all the way up from the feet. Every place was becoming paralyzed. He was talking to his students. When the poison had reached almost at the heart level, he felt he was about to die. He said two words. Number one, he told them, although I'm dying, my soul will not die. Number two, there is a man I owed a cork, please go and pay that cork on my behalf. And then he died. It was written that he died as a nobleman. Now Paul, he knew that. Socrates, the philosopher Socrates had many followers. How would Paul come and tell them that the man he believes was crucified? When we go to debates regarding their philosophy, they will overcome me.
Girende.
What shall I do?
Ibice bibiri.
In chapter 2.
Ku murongo wa kabiri.
Verse 2.
Umurongo wa mbere n'uwa kabiri.
Verse 1 and 2.
Nicyo gituma bene data ubwo nazaga iwanyu ntaje ndi umuhanga n'ityoza yo kuvuga. Cyangwa mfite ubwenge buhebuje mbabwira ibihamya by'Imana. Kuko nagambiriye kutagira ikindi mbamenyesha keretse Yesu Kristo ariwe Yesu Kristo wabambwe. Nabanaga namwe mfite intege nke ntinya mpinda umushyitsi mwinshi. Nibyo navugaga nkabwiriza ntibyari amagambo y'ubwenge yo kwemeza abantu filozofi, ahubwo byari bigaragaza umwuka n'imbaraga.
Beginning with verse 1 to 4. And I, brethren, when I came to you, did not come with excellence of speech or of wisdom, declaring to you the testimony of God. For I determined not to know anything among you except Jesus Christ and Him crucified. I was with you in weakness, in fear, and in much trembling. And my speech and my preaching were not with persuasive words of human wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power. Paul said, when I go to Corinth, I won't say anything else but Christ crucified. That's things they don't understand. But I will use the Spirit of God and the power of God. Listen to what he said. Verse 18 in chapter 1 where we just read. He started by saying,
ijambo ry'umusaraba kubarimbuka n'urupfu. N'urupfu. Ariko kuri twebwe abakizwa n'imbaraga z'ima.
For the message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God.
Kubarimbuka.
Those who are perishing,
ijambo ry'umusaraba n'ubupfu.
The message of the cross is foolishness.
Kuri twebwe abakizwa.
But to us who are being saved,
n'imbaraga z'ima.
It is the power of God.
Rero mu Bayuda n'Abagiriki.
To the Jews and Greeks.
Umuntu wese utemera Yesu.
Anyone who doesn't believe in Jesus.
Ari muri liste y'abarimbuka.
They are on the list of those who are perishing.
Ariko twebwe twemera Yesu.
But us who believe in Jesus.
Dufite imbaraga z'ima.
We have the power of God.
Iyo tuvuze iby'umusaraba.
When we speak of the message of the cross.
Ku Bayuda n'Abagiriki.
To the Jews and Greeks.
Babifata nk'ubupfu.
They take it as foolishness.
Ariko kuri twebwe.
But to us.
Ibyo tuvuga.
What we is the power of God. Here
Paul
was showing another type of people that was produced from these two former tribes. The people who were Greeks but got converted. And the Jews who were converted. They formed another type of people called the Church of God. No longer walking in the practices of Judaism or Greeks. They have their own culture. Where they came from, they had their own practices, and where the Greeks and the Jews came from had their own practices. But where they came now, as they form a new type of people, they have their own culture. In the kingdom of the Jews, they have Jewish and Judaism practices. To the kingdom of the Greeks, they have Greek practices. To the kingdom of Christ, there are Christian practices. Now I don't understand how someone lives in the kingdom of Christ but practices today's Greeks practices or Judaism practices. Yet in Jesus there is a new nation, a new people made of both Jews and Greeks. Yes, they have their origin. Yes, they have their nations
and
identity. But they became a new identity. They have a new identity. Now this one, when we preach the message of the cross to those who are in Christ, that is power. But to the Jews and Greeks, it is perish.
Now,
how will I preach to the Jews? How will I preach to the Gentiles? Because to the Greeks, they want wisdom. Jews, they seek after signs. What happened in the days of Moses when God was going to show himself to the Israelites? God showed them that man is redeemed by next of kin. Now Jesus must be part of them to redeem them. When the Israelites came out of Egypt, they were redeemed by Moses. Moses was their next of kin. He performed signs to prove them. They are still looking for signs like in the days of Moses. God asked him, what do you have? He said, I have a road. Lift up your road. Place it down. Strike that road. Use this road. Signs would happen. And the Jews would say, now we accept. This is our Redeemer. Because we see the Jews look after signs. That's why Paul said, that's why God gave me power to perform miracles for them to believe. Paul would go to the Jews and God would use them to perform miracles. That's why Peter had to walk in the power of miracles, and the crippled were able to walk. The dead were raised. Jesus, his entire life was about miracles. The miracle he performed, they would say, now we believe him. He is greater than other prophets. Who is this man? Who is this man? Miracles made Jews get impressed. So Moses, he had to perform miracles. And the Israelites believe. Every time they complain, he would perform miracles. They would rejoice again. Moses, you are amazing. They would run rejoicing. When they had another problem, they almost stoned him. There's a problem. Moses will perform a miracle. The Jews will rejoice again. You are incredible. The life of Jews is looking for signs. Now Paul had asked for the power of God to use them to perform miracles, so that Jews would believe that Jesus is the same. The same way he was yesterday, he's the same today, and he'll always be.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Signs would be performed. This man is incredible. He has performed signs, miracles. That's why in the book of John, when John is writing the book of John, he begins with the word sign. He begins with sign. John, in writing the gospel, he was addressing Jews, and every time Jesus was performing miracles, John would use the term sign because that's what the Jews were familiar with. But for Matthew and Luke, they used the word miracles because their audience included Gentiles. But for the Gentiles, they wanted wisdom. That's why the Bible says Moses was trained in all the Egyptian wisdom. He had Egyptian wisdom. Even when he claimed he is not good at speech, God gave him a spokesperson in Aaron. And they would go to Aaron, to Pharaoh, and talk. When it was time for wisdom, they would use wisdom. When it was time for signs, they would use signs. Egypt saw the wisdom of God. The Israelites saw the signs of God. And redemption happened.
Abayuda rero barashaka ibimenyetso. Abagiriki bashaka ubwenge.
So the Jews wanted signs and the Greeks were searching after wisdom.
Imana rero ngo igiye gukiza ba.
So when God was going to redeem man,
ntabwo yakoresheje ubwenge bw'isi.
He did not use the wisdom of the world.
Paul nibyo avuga hare.
That's what Paul says.
Imana ikoresha ubwenge bw'isi.
Had God used the wisdom of the world,
baragize umwe bemera n'undi batemera.
They would have had one philosopher, they would follow.
Ariko Imana yazanye ubwenge burenge ubundi bwenge.
But God brought a wisdom superior to all other wisdom.
Imana
God used what was contrary to what they were used to. The Bible says, verse 20, where is the wise? Where is the scribe? Where is the disputer of this age? Has not God made foolish the wisdom of this world? So to the Greeks, this is amazing. A Greek would never accept that man can be redeemed by the cross. That is utterly impossible. That is foolishness to the Greek.
And the Greek would never accept that man can be redeemed by the cross.
And so to the Jews to tell them that the Messiah was born in Bethlehem in Ephrata, the least of all the cities of in Judah, and raised in Nazareth, where the Bible says, can anything good come out of Nazareth? That was amazing. They would claim if the Messiah is to come, he should at least be born in Jerusalem. And so he was a stumbling block to them.
Imana igambiriye gukiza isi.
When God purposed to redeem the world,
yabanje kureba imyemerere n'imyizerere y'abantu.
He first looked at the belief system and the philosophies of men.
Asanga isi irimo ibice bishaka ibimenyetso n'ibindi bishaka ubwenge batoke. Niba ngiye gucungura isi rero ndanyuranya nabyo. Kuko ubwenge bwanje bwo mwijuru tibugendera kuri standard z'ubwenge bw'isi.
God saw that the world had two sections. There was a section of those who are looking for wisdom and another section looking for sign. And so God, I want to do said I want to do things contrary to that thinking system. Verse 21, for since in the wisdom of God the world through wisdom did not know God,
badaheshwa kumenya ubwenge bw'Imana baheshejwe n'ubwenge bw'isi. Imana yashimishije gukirisha abayizera ubupfu bw'ibibwirizwa.
It pleased God through the foolishness of the message preached to save those who believe.
Imana mu bwenge bwayo iradesida.
God in his wisdom decided what people believe is not what I'm going to use. For that reason, I'm going to use what they regard as foolishness. And that foolishness was like weakness. Now listen.
Verse 25.
Because the foolishness of God is wiser than men, and the weakness of God is stronger than men. The cross on which Jesus was hanged, no Greek would ever accept it. But the foolishness of God was pleased that the standard and circumstances of people, the standard of their wisdom could not save them, and therefore for that matter what they disregard, what they despise is what I'm going to use.
Bagenda biyita imfura.
They call them themselves noble.
Imfura.
The nobles.
Mukigiriki barikoresha ngo ni Eugenia, Eugene.
In Greek they use the word Eugene.
Naho muswa bamwita Moro.
But the fool is called moral.
Moro. Niba mukunze kubona hari abantu bavuka badafite ubwenge bwuzuye akageza imyaka 40 agifite imyaka 4 nibo ba moro. Ngo Imana yishimiye gukoresha ba moro ngo isuzuguze ba Eugene.
Morals, if you know, there are people who are born with this natural disability where the growth of their intellect ability is not proportional to their body, and so those are called the morals. And so God was pleased to use the moral to shame those who are wise.
Bimani suzuguza abanyabwenge biyisi mu kigiriki ni sofo havemo sofia nufwe ngo nabantu bemewe nk'intagarugero icyavuze bagifata nga bibiliya ngo abo ngabo Imana irabasuzuguza ikoresha ngo ibinyentege nke nibisuzuguritse cyane. Imana yanze gukorera kuri standard y'abantu kugira ngo ikize abantu, ikorera kuri standard y'ubupfu bw'abantu.
God chose to use the shame to shame the ones of this world. He had to use what they disregarded and despised so that he could despise them and turn to nothing their wisdom. Number one,
no musaraba.
It is the cross. To the Greek, if you brought the cross, it is nothing. Number two, how can Jesus, who raises the dead, fail to save himself? The Greeks could not understand that. You are preaching that he saved man, he raised the dead. How could he die? How could someone who tells death to run away, how could he himself die?
Intege z'Imana zirasoma imbaraga zawe. Yesu yaje mu ntege nke, Yesu ntiyaje mu mbaraga kugira ngo asuzuguze abanyembaraga. Uko niko Imana yakoze ubwenge bwayo bwayitegetse gukirisha iyi si. Ikoresheje ubucucu, ikoresheje intege nke.
God used what the world regarded as foolishness and weakness to shame the strong and the wise of this world.
Umva rero.
Listen.
Umunyabwenge ni
who is the wise?
Umunyabwenge muri sense y'Imana cyangwa mu buryo bw'ubumana.
The wise in God's way of looking at things,
numuntu wemera gukurikira uwabambwe,
is someone who accepts to follow the one who was crucified.
Ariko mu Bagiriki
umunyabwenge ninde? Who is the wise?
Nuwanze kubambwa akica.
Is somebody who refused to be crucified and committed suicide. That is the wise person. A man who refused to be crucified and committed suicide. But the wisdom of God says the man who accepted to be crucified and you follow the crucified Jesus, you are the wise. And so you Greeks, when I came to you to Corinth,
gushira manga n'ubutyoza bwinshi ahubwo nagambiriye muri njyewe kutagira ikindi kintu nzababwira keretse Kristo gusa kandi si Kristo usanzwe uwabambwe.
I did not come to tell you anything against not the wisdom of this world or any persuasive words, but I determined to tell you one thing: Christ alone and him crucified. Christ who was crucified is the one I determined to tell you about. Verse 23, chapter
1.
Verse 22 and 23, for Jews request a sign and Greeks seek after wisdom, but we preach Christ crucified.
Uwo kubayuda ni kigush, kubanyamahanga n'ubupfu.
To the Jews a stumbling block and to the Greeks foolishness.
Ariko kubahamagawe baba yuda n'abagiriki mwumve bwa bwoko bwa gatatu nababwira.
But to those who are called both Jews and Greeks,
umugiriki wemeye Yesu,
a Greek who believed Jesus,
umuyuda wemeye Yesu,
a Jew who believed Jesus,
bahita barobanurwa bakava muri bene wabo.
They will be set apart from their own people,
kuko bagiye kuyoboka ubwenge bwo mu ijuru,
because they are going to follow the wisdom of heaven,
bayobotse imbaraga zo mu ijuru,
they are going to follow the power of heaven,
bayobotse umwuka wo mu ijuru,
the spirit of heaven.
Aba rero,
now this one,
nizo Paul avuga,
that's what Paul says here.
makumyabiri na kane ngo ariko kubahamagawe baba yuda n'abagiriki uwo ni Kristo niwe mbaraga z'Imana niwe bwenge bwayo.
But to those who are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ, the power of God and the wisdom of God.
Kristo,
Christ,
mbaraga z'Imana,
the power of God,
bwenge bw'Imana,
wisdom of God.
Kuri wowe wakijijwe,
to you who is saved,
urimo Kristo.
You have Christ.
Urimo bwenge.
You have the wisdom.
Urimo mbaraga.
And the power.
Ayo na amazina atatu ya Yesu.
Those are three names of Jesus.
Ni Kristo.
He's the Christ.
Ni bwenge bw'Imana.
He's the wisdom of God.
Ni mbaraga z'Imana.
And he's the power of God.
Rero Kristo akurimo.
Now Christ is in.
Kristo bisobanura iki?
What does Christ mean?
Ngo n'ugusigwa.
Anointing.
Iyo twasizwe.
When we are anointed.
Tuhabwa imbaraga zo gucagagura imigozi yose ya karemere na karande yari itubuye.
We receive power to break every chain of generational curses.
Iyo dufite imbaraga zima.
When you have the power of God.
Nta kintu na kimwe kidutera ubwoba.
Nothing can intimidate us.
Iyo dufite ubwenge bw'Imana.
When we have the wisdom of God.
Nta kujijwa tugire.
We have no confusion.
Rero mwaba Korinto.
Now you Corinthians.
Murimo Kristo.
You have Christ.
Murimo imbaraga zima.
You have the power of God.
You
have the spirit of God, the wisdom of God. You have those things in you. Us who have been called, we have Christ, the power of God, the wisdom of God. And so the least or the weakest among us,
kandi ntege z'Imana dirusha abantu imbaraga. Iyo urimo Yesu Kristo, nubwo abantu bagira ngo uri umuswa, urarusha abanyabwenge bose ubwenge.
Because the foolishness of God is wiser than men, and the weakness of God is stronger than men, even if he may seem to be a fool in the eyes of men, because you have Christ and the power of God, you have the wisdom of God greater than men.
Umunyentege nke muri twe.
The weak among us is stronger than many pagans. Says you. You are not an ordinary person. You have the anointing of God that breaks the yoke. You have the wisdom of God. You have the power of God. Anointing. The power of God. And the wisdom of God. Even in your weakest time, you are still stronger than the whole world. Even in your foolishness, you are still wiser than the people of the world. You have anointing that breaks the yoke. Now how can it be that the world will attract you? Your weakness when you are in Jesus is stronger than the men of the world. Your foolishness when you are in Christ is wiser than the wise of the world. Now how can it be that it is not you attracting them but them attracting you? That is what Paul was wondering about. To us,
Kristo kubandi,
Christ to others,
kubayuda
badakije, to the Jews who are unsaved, he's a stumbling block.
Kubagiriki,
to the Greeks,
nubupfu,
he's foolishness.
Ariko kuri twe,
but to us,
ni Kristo,
he is the Christ,
imbaraga z'Imana,
the power of God,
nubwenge bw'Imana,
the wisdom of God.
None bishoboka gute.
Now how can it be?
Bibiliya iravuga ngo,
the Bible says,
intege nke z'Imana,
the weakness of God is stronger than men. The foolishness of God is wiser than men. You have the Christ, the power of God, the authority of God. Why does the world attract you instead of you attracting the world? Because you are superior to them.
Kuki ibintu byo hanze ari byo ukoporora ukabizana mu nzu y'Imana ari byo wambara ari byo ugenderaho nufata umuco w'Imana ahubwo ngubanduze nabo bagusange ibyo bishoboka gute? Burimo Kristo, imbaraga z'Imana, ubwenge bw'Imana. Byagenze gute? N'umunyentege nge muri mwebwe ararusha bisi bose imbaraga, n'umuswa muri mwe ararusha bisi bose ubwenge. Bishoboka gute?
How do you copy the practices of the world and bring them in the church, in the house of God, and begin to imitate the world, yet you are superior to the world? You have Christ in you, you have the power of God in you, you have the wisdom of God in you. How can you go back and begin to behave like the world instead of influencing the world with your practices?
Imana rero yakoresheje abaswa.
So God used the fools
kugira ngo ikoze isoni abanyabwenge,
to shame the wise.
Yatoranije ibinyentege nke,
he chose the weak
kugira ngo ikoze isoni ibikomeye,
to shame the strong.
Imana yatoranije ibyoroheje,
he chose the simple things,
n'ibihinyurwa,
to despise,
to,
and the things that are not are,
kugira ngo ihinyure ibiriho,
to ashamed, to challenge
those
are, so that there will be nobody to glory, to
boast,
who came to God,
uoroheje muma,
the weak in God,
uoroheje,
the simplest. God was pleased to use that person, so that those who regard themselves as strong be ashamed. Now if we contain the power of God, the glory of God, the anointing of God, we must be a peculiar people. Why do you go back to the weak people? Why do we get deceived and attracted by the people who think this is the modern style, yet it is foolishness before God? The Greeks think they are everything, but God chose to use the fools to shame the Greeks. The Jews think they have the God of miracles, but for me, I can use a simple child, a young child who believes to perform miracles. That is the God we believe. That is the message we have. So we preach the gospel, the message of foolishness. When to the Greeks, Socrates was not crucified, but for us, Jesus, he was crucified. Every Greek who believes Jesus shall receive eternal life. Every Jew who believes Jesus, they shall receive eternal life. That is the Christ, the power of God, the wisdom of God.
Yes,
praise God.
Hallelujah.
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 Imbaraga zacu zivahe?
Where is our power coming from?
Vahe.
Where does our wisdom come from?
Vahe.
Where does our anointing come from?
Tabgaribzis.
Not from the world.
Iyisi.
This world.
Imbaraga ziyisi.
The power of this world.
Muri physique babzita pesanteur.
In physics they call it gravity.
Pesanteur nik.
What is the gravitational force? In the French they have that word that means weight.
Heaviness.
When you throw something up, the gravitational force will pull it down. That's why in this world, everyone can be brought low. Everyone who is high can come down. Whoever promotes themselves can come down. But the power from God, the power from God, the wisdom from God comes from above. Just like the heavens are higher than the earth, that's how the wisdom of God is spirit, not of man. Just as the heavens are higher than the earth, that's how the ways of God are above the ways of man. We have the wisdom of heaven. We have the power of heaven. We have the anointing of heaven. That's why the world cannot attract us. Even when it tries, it will fail. What proved that is in the resurrection and the ascension of Jesus Christ. Try it and do it again. If you take a step to go up, you go faster. But Jesus ascended in their eyes. The cloud covered him.
The world could not pull you down because they are the power of heaven. We are of heaven. Although we are in the world, we have the power of heaven, the wisdom of heaven, the anointing of heaven. Whatever happens, the world has no power over. The world cannot change. The world cannot overcome us. The world cannot defeat us. We have the power of Christ. The power that took him to heaven, that brought him from among the dead, is the power working in us. To you who believe, he is Christ, the power of God, the wisdom of God. Oh, does that come from? It came from heaven.
Hey, hallelujah!
Glory to God!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Let me tell you. When someone is above you, they are above you. What is above always controls what is below. When someone is older than you, they are older than you. When you are wise, you humble yourself before them. If you are a fool, you want to confront them. The power of the world cannot challenge the power of heaven. It is impossible. That is the principle. It is a principle. You cannot fight the one who is above you. The power of God operating in the world came in form of weakness, and people despised it. And now it started from the roots all the way it changed, and the wisdom of God came in foolishness and people did not care about it. It entered gradually until they bowed down. They bowed down and said, there's no other name except the name of Jesus. Say, the Spirit of God. Did you hear what we have? We have the anointing of God, the wisdom of God, the power of God. Now listen to the third thing that we have, which is where I want to end. I wish this service would become an overnight service so that we continue. God, make this service like an overnight service. Because my time is up. And I need to go and preach somewhere at 3 p.m. At 5, I'll be here. I have no choice but to close. Listen, let me tell you.
En fait, iyo turimo dukora utundu twisi twibyato baturimo dusuzuguza imbaraga ziturimo.
When we
icyo kibabaza Imana, Imana ntibabazwa ko wakoze icyaha uri mu mubiri w'ibyaha di premier utrane. Ibabazwa nuko ziriya mbaraga bazimshize hasi. Buriya bwenge wabuparitse.
God is offended when we begin to do the things of the world, the sins of the world, because that is disgracing his power that is in you.
Jesus. Okay, reka nihute. Eh, kabiri gatandatu. Abakorinto ba mbere kabiri gatandatu.
1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 6.
Muranyihangana nk'iminota 10 ningahe ucya.
Can you give me some 10 minutes?
Muyimpa kanya.
Please give me some 10 minutes. So that I finish this message well. I invite you to the overnight on Friday.
Ngubwenge tuvuga mu batunganijwe rwose. Voilà. subwo kuguha ingurube. Yesu yaravuze ngo ntuzafata imarigarita ngo uyambike ingurube ihita ijya mu cyondo kwinezeza. Wayambitse karuvate nziza na marigarita na shenete ya noro ngo ngurube tujye mu bukwe, warebaga tugasanga yageze mu cyondo deja. Ngo ubu bwenge mbabwira tubuvuga mu batunganijwe. Subwenge upfa kuvuga n'importe ubu, tubuvuga mu batunganijwe kuko barabwumva.
Chapter 2, verse 6. However, we speak wisdom among those who are mature, not to anyone but the mature.
Hey, ngwari kubwo bwenge subwiki gihe cyangwa ubwo abatware biki gihe bashiraho, ahubwo tuvuga ubwenge bw'ubwiru bw'Imana. Voilà le mystère. Ngwari byo bwenge bwahishwe Imana yaringanisha ibihe byose bitarabaho ngo buduheshe icyubahiro. Iyo ufite ububwenge ugira icyubahiro.
Yet not the wisdom of this age nor of the rulers of this age who are coming to nothing, but we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, the hidden wisdom which God ordained before the ages for our glory. When you have this wisdom, you have glory.
Aba ni bande?
Who are these?
Abatware, abakomeye b'iki gihe. Niba abanditsi n'abafarisayo birirwaga batwara ibi bibiliya n'ibitabo binini bazi ngo masiya azaza, naho Yesu abarimo muri simplicity.
Who are these rulers? They were the Pharisees and the scribes who had the scrolls always walking with them religiously, yet Christ was in their midst in simplicity.
Mu gitondo nabyukanye ijambo mu mutwe.
I woke up this morning with the word in my mind of a man called Simeon. The day Jesus was born,
Simeon,
they brought the baby Jesus that Simeon would bless him. And he blessed him. And then he proclaimed powerful things over Jesus. And he said to the mother of Jesus, I was wondering, imagine a man like Simeon who held God in his arms and proclaimed the blessing about God. What position will he have in the kingdom of God? You will never hear of him anywhere. He is among the simplest men. We speak the wisdom of God to those who are mature. Simeon was not known. Pharisees were famous. None of them knew that Jesus has come to the temple at the age of 8 days. But Simeon held him. Do you know what he said? He said, Lord, now you may let your servant go, for he has seen the salvation of your people. He was talking to a baby of 8 days. Lord, you may let your servant go. He had the wisdom to know that in this baby was a king, in this baby was a God. The wise of this age did not know that. The wisdom, the wise of this age could not know that.
Kuko iyo baza kubumenya ntibabarabanze umwami w'icyubahiro.
Verse 8, which none of the rulers of this age knew, for had they known, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory.
Ngwariko ngo biranditswe ngo ibyijisho ritigeze kureba n'ibyugutwi kutigeze kumva ibitigeze kwinjira mu mutima w'umuntu, ibyo byose Imana yabiteguriye abayikunda mwebwe.
But as it is written, eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love him.
Uyu murongo,
this verse,
ni afete ni explication y'umurongo wa karindwi.
It is the explanation of verse 7.
ahubwo tuvuga ubwenge bw'ubwiru bw'Imana ari bwo bwenge bwahishwe Imana yaringanirije ibihe byose bitarabaho ngo buduheshe icyubahiro ku murongo wa 9 rero ibyijisho ritigeze kureba ugutwi gutigeze kumva ibitigeze byinjira mu mutima w'umuntu ibyo byose Imana bibikiye twebwe nitwe tuzi ubwiru bw'Imana.
But we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, the hidden wisdom which God ordained before the ages of our glory. Verse 9, he explains that further. He said, but as it is written, eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love him. How did we receive that revelation? How do we know what others don't know? How do we know that in the cross crucified, dispersed by others, is power and life? Where do we get that wisdom?
Because
what I'm telling is not taught in kindergarten, in primary, in secondary, in university, until all the way to your PhD levels. The universities of this world do not teach about it. Where do we get this wisdom? Where do we get this wisdom? Verse 10.
Ngwari kwimana yabiduhishurishije umwuka wayo.
But God has revealed them to us through His Spirit. Said so the Spirit of God. The Spirit of God. For the Spirit searches all things. Yes, the deep things of God. This is what Paul is saying. We are here in the world, but we receive the Spirit of God, who searches hearts of men and gives us to search the mysteries of God. You can be living in your simple heart, eating ordinary food, but you begin to download the strength from the heart of God. The wise of this world, the strong of this world, the wealthy of this world have no clue, because they live by the wisdom of the Greeks. But for us, it is through the Spirit of God. Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, Pharaoh went to consult from a Hebrew boy who was in prison to interpret his dream. When Joseph interpreted the dream, Pharaoh said, you have a spirit of God in you. We have another spirit. Now Paul makes it clear logically. Verse
11.
For what man knows the things of a man except the spirit of the man which is in him? Let me stop for a moment. Can I ask you a question? Tell me what I thought. Except the spirit in me knows my thoughts. What man can know what is in the heart of a man except the spirit of that man in him? Now let's go on.
Hey! Ngo nibyimana niko biri tawabimenyere tawabimenya keretse umwuka wayo.
Even so, no one knows the things of God except the Spirit of God.
Iyo ushaka kumenya Imana,
when you want to know God,
ugomba kuba ufite umwuka wayo.
You must have the Spirit of God.
Iyo umuntu akijijwe nuko umwuka w'Imana aba yamugezemo.
When someone gets saved, it is because of the work of the Spirit of God. Makes them understand and convicts them of their sin. Verse
12.
No. Ahubwo twahawe uwo mwuka uva ku mana kugira ngo tumenye iby'Imana yaduhereye ubuntu.
Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit who is from God, that we might know the things that have been freely given to us by God.
Twebweho
to us,
titwahawe umwuka w'isi.
We have not received the spirit of the world, but the people of the world, they have the spirit of the world. How do we know the spirit of the world? Jealous. When someone has jealous, true jealous, even if they had 10 cars and you have one car, they will be jealous of you. Do you know what they want? They want you to lose it so that you begin to walk.
Pesanteur, gravité.
Gravity, gravitational force, pulls. That person wants to advance ahead of me, pull them down again. That one is going to become prominent, pull them down again. That is the spirit of the world. Now Paul says, for us we have the spirit from above, from God. Now if God is above, the spirit of above of heaven is different from that of the world. When something tries to rise up, the gravitational pull will bring it down. But the spirit of above, the spirit of heaven, wants everything to go above.
In fact, hejuru hari umwuka.
There is a spirit above that wants to raise everything here in the world. There is a spirit in the world that wants to pull down everything that is above. And so he said to the Corinthians, us, we have the spirit of
heaven.
How come we don't pull the non-believers to take them above to God, but we are pulled by the non-believers to come down? You get it now? When you have the spirit of God, The spirit, what will tell you the spirit of God in you is when someone who has the spirit of God will always celebrate and appreciate everything good happening to their colleague. But those with the spirit of the world, they will always try to condemn, they'll try always to bring down anything that is good for another person. That's how you know who has which spirit next to you. Verse 13, these things we also speak, not in words which man's wisdom teaches, but which the Holy Spirit teaches, comparing spiritual things with spiritual. What we teach is not from man, not from the world, but from the Spirit of God who comes from above. Another thing, we compare spiritual things, or we explain spiritual things by the Spirit. When we are going to give explanations about the spiritual things, we get that explanation from the Holy Spirit. Verse 14.
Uyu munyamubiri.
ngo ntiyemere iby'umwuka w'Imana kuko ari ubupfu kuri we. Ahandi bavuze umupagani, no, bavuze umunyamubiri. Umunyamubiri ni umukristo wapfuze, ni umukristo. Ibintu byose ashyira muri logique. Uzakora logique wewe mu rugo, uyikore ku kazi no mu rusengero wizane, ariko mwaragowe n'ama logique. Hari ahantu zidakoreka mu mwuka, nta logique. Haba logique y'umwuka, kuko ab'umwuka basobanuza iby'umwuka, ibindi by'umwuka. Iyo ushaka kuzana akantu kose ngo ugashyire mu mwuka mu rusengero, ufite ibyago. Bikorere iwawe mu rugo, bikorere hanze, ariko aha ni umwuka, ni umwuka. Abo bakamere rero ngo ibintu abanyamwuka bakora babyita iki? Ubupfu. Yarangiza akabwira mugenzi wawe ubuye ariko biriya bintu ngeze simbimetriza neza, urabimetriza urinde, banza umetrize umwuka. Urajya kumetriza ibitametrizwa, va mu mubiri ujye mu mwuka. Niko bigomba kumenya, va mu mubiri ujye mu mwuka. Reka dukomeze gatoya. Ngo umuntu wa kamere ntiyemere iby'umwuka w'Imana kuko ari ubupfu kuri we, ngo akaba atabasha kubimenya. Vraiment afite c'est l'impossible, impossibilité, ntashobora na gato kubimenya. Kandi abo nibo bateza ibibazo mu itorero, abo bantu kandi baba ari benshi uretse muri Zayoni. Mwebwe muri mu mwuka, niyo mpamvu mwatumye ntamera imvi. Nuko muri abanyamwuka muranyorohereza akazi. Good. Ngo ntibashobora na gato kubimenya, ngo kuko bisobanurwa mu buryo bw'umwuka.
But the natural man, in other words the carnal man, does not receive the things of the Spirit of God,
yes,
for they are foolishness to him.
Foolishness.
Nor can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned.
Spiritual what?
Spiritually discerned.
Wow. Bateye ubwoba. 15. Ngo ariko umuntu w'umwuka. Yo. Vuga ngo njyewe.
Say me.
Bibe gutyo nyine kuvuye umwanya bivuze. Subiramo vuga ngo njyewe.
Repeat and say me.
Umunyamwuka.
The spiritual.
Umuntu w'umunyamwuka arondora byose, nyamara we ntawumurondora.
But he who is spiritual judges all things, yet he himself is rightly judged by no one.
Biragoye rero kuzuri mu mubiri ngo utangire gucira urubanza umunyamwuka.
It is therefore difficult for you to come in your carnality and begin to judge a spiritual person.
Uzanye umubiri wawe mu by'Imana ngo iyagire iyagi urinde wowe uri mu mubiri dabo.
You come in your flesh, in your carnality, and begin to say, had he
done this?
How can you guide the spiritual when you are in the flesh? It is impossible. What you could do possibly is to speak out and to slander. But to have any spiritual impact is impossible.
Umwuka,
the spirit,
ngo umunyamwuka ntawumurondo, ngo ariko we arondora bose.
He who is spiritual judges all things, yet he himself is rightly judged by no one.
Nanibuka kera nari ngiye kwigisha ku nkuru nziza.
I remember long ago I was going to minister at inkuru nziza.
Vakacyiru ni kacyi sinzando nari mvuye fata bus.
I took a bus from Kachiru.
Tugeze kuri peyaje.
When we came to peyaje,
none mbona umusore twicara.
I saw a young man seated with me in the bus.
Ku ruhanga rwe hari handitse ngo,
on his forehead was these words,
ngo nibye ibihumbi 50,000.
I stole 50,000 Rwandan francs.
nareba gutya namazo simbibona ariko mu bundi buryo nkabona biranditse none birankomplika.
I'll try to look at him physically and could not see it, but in another realm, in the spiritual realm, I could see those words on his forehead. When we had come to a place called Peyage, I said, no way. Let me tell him. If it is true, that's okay. If it is not, that's still okay. So I said, praise the Lord. He was a young man. He said, praise God. I said, I look at your forehead, I see these words saying, I have stolen 50,000 francs. He said, is it appearing on my forehead, on my face? I said, yes.
Ngo nibye patro subi iwachi gitaramo niko yarambwiye ngo nayibye patro none ngi iwachi gitaramo.
He said, I just stole that money from my boss, now I'm running to going back to my village in Gitarama.
Ndamubwira ngo ururukiye wavuba uyasubizeyo.
I said, get out of the bus now, go back and return the money to your boss.
Bati none se ko ndafita nsubizayo namubwira fata muri yayandi uje kumubwira ibyakubayeho nukuraho 200 ya moto nta kibazo ugira cyangwa se 50 ya bus.
He said, I have no extra money for transport to go back, he may arrest me. I said, use that money to pay for the transport.
Umusore,
the young man,
aravuga ngo urakoze,
said thank you.
Mumasareba ntiwabibona,
in physical eyes you could not see,
ariko ko turi abanyemuka turondora,
but because we are spiritual and we can discern. The young man went back. Then later, when we, after many years after we had moved here, he came to this church with a motorcycle. He was wearing his helmet. He came and greeted me. He said, I'm that young man who had the words on my forehead saying, I have stolen 50,000 francs. He told me what happened. He said, my boss came. I went and knelt before him. He said that day I did not take a motorcycle. I walked. I saw a powerful God. I walked from Peyage to Remera. When my boss came, I told him. And my boss was amazed as well. He said, I need to see that man.
He
said, I don't know that man. We just met in the bus. Then later, when we started a church in Remera, when we came here, that young man recognized me. He came and introduced himself. He said, now my boss got saved, but he's no longer working in Rwanda. He went abroad. Now I'm a preacher in the Pentecostal church. From that day,
hallelujah,
hallelujah, the Spirit of God gives us the ability to discern. Watch out, who knows what is written in your forehead. For you are spiritual. Verse 16, as I close,
nyamara twebwe dufite gutekereza kwa Kristo.
For who has known the mind of the Lord that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ. We, the spiritual sons. This is what Paul says. We have power to enter the mind of God and know what is in
him.
By what means? By the Spirit who came from the heart of God and came in us. Long ago, I used to see, I don't know what is still happening. When a lady went to shop in a distance, in a long place, leaving a baby behind, there were signs that would happen to the mother to tell her that a baby is crying back home. And she could feel it, that the baby is having a problem, and she would come back running. My baby is crying. I don't know how they discern that. Sometimes through their breast milk, or through their womb, or through their heart. But they would feel something wrong has happened to their baby. It is because the spirit of the baby is also in the mother. And so God has placed us here on earth, and He is in heaven. So that we may know His mind, He gave us a network by giving us His spirit. So that makes us able to know what is on the mind of God. We know the desire of God. And then we act according to the way God leads us. So when someone is in the spirit, because the world cannot discern him, what he does, led by the spirit, the world people will not understand except God alone. Another thing, they will have the mind of God, because God also controls his mind. The reason why God knows us is because he breathed his spirit upon us. Where you sleep, where you spend your day, God knows you, because he placed his spirit in you. So for us to know what is in heaven, we must be having the spirit of heaven, and that makes us walking in that power. Now, what is Paul's question? Brethren, you have power to know even what is in the farthest country by billions of kilometers away. You are even able to know what is in the heart of God. So how can it be that you cannot know what is in the heart of a man who is deceiving you? If you can discern and know what is in the heart of God, what is asking us now is asking us to ask him again for his anointing, for his power, for his wisdom, and his spirit. These four will make your life never to be held by the world. Christ, which is the anointing, wisdom, which is the wisdom of God, power, the power of God, and the spirit of God. May God bless you for me. May the Lord be gracious to you. May the Lord enable you. Please stand up for prayer. After our service, if you want to give your life to Jesus, I will invite you to come forward, that you may walk in the wisdom of God. God, I pray for your people, for the wisdom from above, wisdom given by you, wisdom that you give, the wisdom that is special. I thank you, Father. I thank you, Daddy, for opening the door to receive your power, your spirit, your wisdom and your anointing. Everyone here, let them walk with that portion, that we will not be with the world. Let them not be attracted by the world, but let them attract the world. Thank you, for we have your mind, and we are going to walk with them for the rest of our days. In the name of Jesus. Amen. You may go home with the Lord Jesus. We'll see you on Tuesday. If you haven't given your life to Jesus, please come forward now. And the Lord bless you. We are waiting for you. Please come. Come and receive Jesus.
nawe urimo dukurikira kuri mudasobwa turagusaba ngo wakire agakiza cyangwa kuri televiziyo cyangwa kuri radio.
And if you are following us live online or watching on TV or listening to the radio, you want to give your life to Jesus, join us in this session of giving your life to Jesus shortly. Come and receive Jesus.
We know what kire Yesu.
Come and receive Jesus.
Tugiye gusengera.
We are going to pray for you.
Abageza aha.
Those who are here.
Shima Yesu.
Thank you, Jesus.
Namwe murimo mudukurikira.
And those of you who are following on TV or radio or online.
Namwe. Turasaba ngo mwakira gakiza.
We ask you to receive Jesus in your life. Please close your eyes and repeat after this prayer.
Mwami Yesu, subiramo Mwami Yesu.
Repeat and say, Lord Jesus,
ndi umunyabyaha.
I'm a sinner.
Mbabarira.
Forgive me.
Ibyaha nakoze byose.
All the sins I committed.
Andika izina ryanjye.
Write my name
mu gitabo cyawe.
In your book.
Kuko nkwizeye.
Because I believe you.
Ku Mwami n'Umukiza.
As my Lord and Savior of my life, be in me and rule me. Your blood, let it cleanse me. Thank you, Jesus, for revealing yourself to me and setting me free in this moment. I'm free. Make me the person you want me to be. That I will serve you for the rest of my life. Your word has touched me. That's why I came here. Fill me with your wisdom, your power, your anointing, and your spirit. In your name, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Ndagira ngo muvugane n'uyu mupapa zamura koko kwawe hari cyo baganirizaho gitoya mukabona gutaha sibyo murakoze kuba mwakiriye Yesu mugize neza ni intambwe ikomeye mugezeho murakoze mumwegere hari.
Please go and meet that gentleman there. He has a few words for you of encouragement. Thank you for coming. God bless you.